This is your man Jaquan, the Foundation. I'm hopping off into my funk segment of the Foundation. And this is the video blog for the funk section of the Foundation. My first installment, the first artist that I'm going to showcase is my man, the funky drummer, Class Stubblefield.
And my snare's going.
Responsible for Funky Drummer, Give It Up, Turn It Loose. You know, him and Jabbo Sparks, you know, the drummers for James Brown, just created such a backdrop for hip hop, you know, and names just aren't household. And the Funky Drummer in particular is a record that the first time I heard it was probably Sweet Tease, It's My Beat, which is a rap record. Then again, on it's a demo by the incredible Kool G Rap. And I think I heard it once before that on a more obscure record. I have to ask my man El Bravador. He used to play it on the radio back in the days on WKIE. It was a real obscure record that had the funky drummer in it. And it just exploded. And, you know, from I'd say probably 86, 87 on up through the so-called golden era. One of the reasons that the golden era was golden was because of the funky drummer. I mean, there would be no Public Enemy, not on the scale that they made it. Without Funky Drummer, I mean Rebel Without a Pause, Bring the Noise, so many records of theirs had the Funky Drummer.
Yes, the rhythm, the rebel, without a pause, I'm lowering my level. Never batted and bad, cause a brother is madder than mad at the fact that's corrupt like a senator. Soul on the road, but you treat it like soap on a rope, cause the beats and the lines are so dope.
Wanted man, from a wanted clan, wanted by every fan across the land. G-A-N-G off the street, R-U. Complete.
Everybody either cut that record up or rhymed over that record. It's just a huge record. I mean, you know the Funky Drummer when you hear it, but you don't know that it's actually somebody drumming necessarily. Hip-hoppers know it's Class Stubblefield, but the world at large does not know that this record, you know, is this breakdown. It's like an 8 or 9 minute record that had a 20 second breakdown, and we took it and looped it and just made it something so big. And of course, you know, I'm sure at the time Class Stubblefield wasn't getting any royalties. I mean, James Brown probably wouldn't even getting the proper royalties he was supposed to get. So I'm sure he just got a standard union musician's fee for playing in that session, which could have been $100 or so. Like the Motown artists or Motown musicians like the Funk Brothers, you know, would get, you know, a few dollars for playing on a session that ended up being a monumental, you know, billion-dollar producing session. And that's as it goes with Class Stubblefield. He played on this record. There was an obscure record in his day. We come back, you know, 20, 30 years, sample it, and people still using pieces of the Funky Drummer today. People was cutting up different parts of it.
Work me to death. It's in my shirt. You better work me to death. It's in my shirt. I walk the floor. I want to walk the floor.
Also spoke of Give It Up or Turn It Loose, and that breakdown you hear, you know, the clap your hands, stomp your feet, and then when James Brown goes Clyde and Clyde starts playing, it's just incredible. And at the time we didn't even know that it was saying Clyde, we just thought it was more of James Brown's noises and grunts.
Clyde.
One, two, three. I was just hitting, it wasn't going. Okay, the spare is the original. The live version, I played it more with a 4/4 bill, right, without the backbeat coming back, hitting back, cop. So,
but I think what people really want to hear and see is the famous breakdown.
Okay. You know,
they're gonna clap your hands, stomp your feet, clap your hands, stomp your feet, clap.
In their records was cutting up the little Clyde, and they didn't know they were cutting up somebody's name. It's just something that sounded good, like you know, James Brown, little grunts and squeals and hollers always did sound good. So this is the story, or a very small portion of the story on my video blog, of the funky drummer Clyde Stubblefield, and hopefully this will be a small step towards getting some props and recognition for the man who made one of the most sampled, if not the most sampled records for the hip-hop genre and other genres also, and probably one of the most important break beats in all of hip-hop to me. And on top of it just being a funky breakdown, is just such a complicated thing to play. I think the only other drum sequence I could think of that's that hard to play would be the one from 7779311. By the time that it's rumored that Prince actually played the drum pattern.
Just a that's a that, and that's where I do my, that's, I came up with that out of the blue, so it's my idea of how I feel the funk should be.
The name of this tune is the Funky Drummer. 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 The Funky Drummer.